It is I, the Bucket Genie, here to give you more Paper Mario the Thousand Year Door. I am the Max of Few Trades. In the last part, we finished off our moon expedition, and we have all the crystal stars, and now we can go through the Thousand Year Door. However, before we do any of that such nonsense, you know, rescuing the world and the princess and whatnot, I figured we should probably check in on our good old Super Bro Luigi to see how his little adventure ended up going. Let's see, adventures. Oh, of course, me. I'm done questing for now. Yep, I scaled Hatesong Tower the other day and rescued the fair Princess Eclair. That's one adventure I'm never gonna forget. Nope, it was just too exciting. It was just bonkers, bro. Wanna hear what happened? Of course I do! You're going to not tell me the ending of this epic tale saga thing that you're doing? Well, like I said, it's a really long story and the part is just crazy, but here goes. Hatesong Tower stands atop a jagged, unclimbable cliff beyond the northernmost sea. The winds whistle down the cliff, howling like banshees singing songs of hate and malice and other things of that nature. People say it's pretty much the scariest place in the world, and I had to go there. Blocking out the bone-chilling howls, I somehow managed to reach the tower's door. I was terrified, but thoughts of Princess Eclair warmed my heart and gave me power. All of my companions felt the same way. They were with me to the bitter end, for whatever reason. The door to the tower swung slowly open to reveal an inconceivable darkness. I tried to call out Princess Eclair's name, but I couldn't even breathe because, as I strained my eyes in the darkness, I saw the most terrifying beast of all. The Chestnut King himself appeared before me. He was monstrous and drooling. Very unsanitary, I must say. Puddles of toxic goo dripped from his mouth, melting the very ground at our feet. So you're fighting a xenomorph. Okay, good to know. I couldn't stop shaking, but I gritted my teeth and faced the evil beast dead on. I dodged the king's fangs, jumped on his chest, and gave him a hammer whack. My swing split the air and crashed dead center onto the Chestnut King's skull. Hope powered me up, bro. I was going toe-to-toe with the king, and I was loving it. This is it, I thought. I can win this. I'll risk it all on my next blow. I gripped my hammer tight and waited for the moment. The tension stung me. Shwack! The ocean winds raged against the tower windows. With that sound, as my call to battle, I advanced with no mercy in my heart. And then... I beat him. I defeated the Chestnut King. Traumatic effect! And even worse beast came next. A nightmare thing. But I beat it too. I rescued Princess Eclair and it was all over. And then I came back to Rogueport and had a light lunch. And that's about it. Huh? You think there's more to the story than that? Not at all. That's it. That's the whole story of the quest for Princess Eclair. The end. But my adventures won't end here, bro. They'll never end. Well, he's clearly not telling us something. Bluey, do you have any idea? Also, you seem to be even more Kentucky Fried than you once were. What's up with that? Hey, you, remember me? It's me, Bluey. Man, that last battle was hairy. You have no idea. I was burnt to a crisp, but I was actually kind of relieved, if you can believe that. But if you want the whole story, you should just ask Luigi here. Well, I already asked Luigi, and he did not give me the information I required. Either way, it seems like his epic quest ultimately yielded positive results, and I suppose that's all that matters. And if you thought that was all we were gonna get out of Luigi's epic saga, you were wrong, because I have in my hands the next book in the series, Super Luigi 4. The Shards of Truth. Footsore and weary, Luigi finally found the rapturous ruins beyond Gribble Forest. Within them, time and space were lost in nothingness. Within the pale emptiness, Luigi found a young sleeping boy. Our hero called out gently, and the youth woke from his long, long slumber. My name is Cranberry, and I've waited for you for the last 1,000 years, the boy went on to tell Luigi the secret truths of an ancient land. He said that the marvelous compass had been created by the ancient Luff people, who used its powers to foretelling to rule the world. But the Luff Empire was then cursed by the compass and fell into ruin. The survivors dismantled the compass and hid its pieces. Cranberry was the last of the ancient race. His role was to wait until one with a noble heart came to take the burden of the future. None but Luigi could have shouldered this weight. The boy gave him the compass piece and said, "Fear the curse, but find your Eclair." Luigi accepted a part. The boy's words burned into his brain. His duty fulfilled, the boy began to fade into the blank nothingness. As he faded from sight, a look of joy lit Cranberry's face. As Luigi gaped, or whatever that word is, both boy and ruins vanished, leaving our hero in a dark wood. With six of the parts united, the compass now pointed to the final part. To the quest's end. To Hatesong Tower. And then her voice spoke. Princess Eclair's voice begged for help from the void, pleading for our hero Luigi's heart burst of flame. To be continued. That's right, there's one last book in the saga, and we won't be able to see that until after we've finished our quest. So we should probably go ahead and do that so we can read the next book. Also, so we can, you know, save the planet and Princess Peach and all that other stuff. Basically, all of the reasons are just kind of piling up that this is a thing that we should really probably, you know, get the lead out of our pants and start doing. Also, you might have noticed, while I was gone, I went back to the Glitz Pit and got the Champ's Belt back. I don't know why I went and did that, I just did. So, that's something that happened. Again, you could foresee that as being dawdling and, you know, procrastinating and whatnot. However, I say shut up, I do what I want. Either way, we're gonna go finally gonna open up that accursed thousand-year door and finally see what's on the other flippin' side. Even though it's very obviously a trick, and the professor, frankly, that's telling us to do this is very clearly dupless, but hey, sometimes heroes gotta be stupid in order for plot progression to truly take effect. That's just how the world works sometimes. Regardless, let's shatter reality with the power of the map once more. It all comes down to this. Hurry now, Mario. Hold aloft that list crystal star. Well, actually, the map has nothing to do with anything anymore. It's all just crystal star power up in here. They are very pretty, I will give it that. A lot of unnecessary teleporting on the Crystal Star's part. Whoa! Eep! Look! The door! Oh my god, someone installed neon lights! I didn't know we were in Vegas. Do doors normally pulsate? Okay, that's different. Uh-huh. Yeah, I totally want to go in there after that. At long last, the entrance to the Palace of Shadow has been opened. Before Princess Peach falls victim to that fiend, before he takes over the world, you must rescue the princess and stop this cataclysm. I'm ready, Mario. Well, I suppose someone in our team is gonna have to be, because how anyone would be willing to walk into something like that after what we just saw and witnessed, I do not fully understand. But I am Mario, by gosh darn it, and I must save the universe yet again. That's just how his life tends to go about. Also, door closed in behind us. Not sure why or how. Very unfortunate. Chapter 8. The Thousand Year Door. Not the Thousand Year Bologna Sandwich. No, it's the door. I mean, come on now. What else could it be? I mean, how on earth did that door know that we walked through it? Also, apparently there was a second door? I don't even know. It's very confusing. This place is gigantic, I'll tell you that much. This place is unsettling, but we have no choice. We have to get in there and save Peach before things get any more out of control. Let's go, Mario. Ain't gotta tell me twice, Lady Type. Let's do this thing. The Palace of Shadow. Ominous, creepy, beautifully decorated. These are all words that I would use to describe such events. Alright, let's see. Well, obviously there's gonna be stuff over down here or something. Why would they lie to me in such a way? Aha! Found a stopwatch. Will that come in handy at any point in time? I have absolutely no clue. What I do know is that that is some sort of gray demon bat. Yeah! Ain't having none of your bat-like shenanigans this day. I've got far more bigger fish to fry. And I'm not even big on eating fish. I mean, if that's your thing, that's cool, but it ain't mine. Alright, so let's just, power slam our way out of this place. Get Vivian. Vivian, could you fire thwack that bat? I'm doing so because, hey, EXP points mean, you know, levels up, which means better chances of survival in this godforsaken hellscape. I don't even know how this place came to be. The Mushroom Kingdom, as an entirety, or the Mushroom World, I suppose, is, like, packed to the brim with, like, so many mystical items and terrifying locations and horrible artifacts of ancient power that will destroy everything everywhere. It's more than a little unsettling if you really get down to think about it. I mean, how many times has the universe, like, you know, come into the balance and almost died, you know, almost killed everyone everywhere? I mean, that's excluding Bowser, okay? I mean, let's be honest. 9 times out of 10, Bowser doesn't really do anything all that bad, really, okay? I mean, yeah, he takes Peach, and that's pretty messed up, but it's become kind of garden variety at this point. All he really wants to do is rule the kingdom, and at this point, it's obvious he's never going to succeed, which is why Mario always invites him go-karting into the golf course, because they both know it's a fruitless endeavor, but hey, why not? Since we're here, might as well. So basically, there's that, but then there's, like, you know, there was Smithy, and then there's the ancient demon, and then there was whatever the hell was going on in the Super Paper Mario game, and then there was the Cacalita and the Shrewd Princess and Anastasia. So much evil! So much evil in this world! And Mario is always there to womp all up on its face. And you know what? It's not even excluded to Mario. Donkey Kong and Wario live in the same universe, so even though they have different stories, it all takes place in the same universe, basically. So things like King K. Rool, that giant Arctic walrus and Tropical Freeze, I haven't played that game yet, so I don't actually know his name, but it gets the point across. Captain Syrup, all those other things, Rudy the Clown. So much nonsensical evil all up in this place, man. It's like, everyone's like, oh, look at the Mario universe. It's so happy and carefree and adorable. But not really. There is a whole lot of messed up evilness going up in this place. It's just buried deep down within its core that you don't ever really see. It's very, very interesting when you think about it. And he's throwing bones. Dude's got a bone to pick with me? Is that what you're trying to say, Sir Bros-a-Lot? Because I ain't having that. I jump on your face. There we go. It may not have done enough damage to kill you, but it'll do enough damage to ultimately kill you. You have won the battle, but I've won the war, so neener 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 to you, good sir. Ha ha! Alright. Getting real close to that level up. Okay, give me all your monies. And okay, I don't want to fight any more of your bat-like peoples. I mean, I'm not racist against bats. It took me 2 years to get over my penguin racism. Don't make me get angry at the bats, okay? That's just me. These guys are gonna keep trying to throw bones, and they're easy to dodge, which is good, because they're like the only enemies that don't try to charge you. Either way, giant golden bullet bills! Anyone who actually knows anything about the material of gold would know it would make absolutely terrible... it's a terrible material to make armors and weapon out of, because it's actually, out of all the metals, extraordinarily fragile. So, making bullets out of gold? Well, I guess it would still, like, kill the person you're trying to fight, but at the same time, I mean, it's exponentially more expensive for literally the same result. And, like, gold-plated cannons? Like, who are you even trying to impress at this point? I mean, nobody gets in here. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. I think it's time to bring out another little old side tangent. Ahem. I thought that this was the 1,000-year super evil door that nobody has ever been in for over 1,000 years. Not a speck of life anywhere to be ever seen. Except for all of the dry bones and bats that we've been fighting. I'm just throwing this out here, but the Glitz Pit also very, very clearly demonstrated that not only do those swooper bat guys, not only are they capable of intelligent speech and thought, so are dry bones. So here's the question that I'm going to ask. How did they get in here? And why are they in here? How are they not dead? Clearly, there's no food of any sort in this place for them to eat. I do not understand how this is supposed to work. It's all very confusing. I mean, okay, sure, fine, whatever, but I don't know. It's a minor little nitpick. I'm not gonna let something like that, you know, once again, it's you're questioning silliness in a video game. If there were no monsters in the final area of the game, obviously it wouldn't be any... It wouldn't be like a big climactic finale if you just sort of waltzed on in and absolutely unimpeded after all. I mean, I get it. I'm not dumb, I understand. It's just, you know, if you really get down and think about it, it's a little bit odd is all. That's all I'm trying to say. Either way, some sort of weird pill bug landed on my head and made me dizzy. Didn't seem to affect anything though, so there you go with that. Fantastic. And it should take care of those freaking gold... I'm going to assume they're gold plated because solid gold cannons? That's just absolutely ridiculous. Why would you even do something like that? Also, those are happening. I forgot about this room. Ooh, the All or Nothing badge. Hit action commands, attack rises. Fail and it drops to zero. Basically, literally exactly as it sounds. If you successfully do the action commands, your attacks are stronger. If you screw them up, they do absolutely no damage whatsoever. So, there you go. If you're really good at the action commands, go for it. I think I'd probably be able to make good use of it, but at the same time, I don't really see a point. I'm pretty comfortable with my power level as is. Just gotta watch out for all these spikes. Just follow the path. Be slow enough so you don't get skewered. Just walk, walk, walk. Okay, that path is clearly not the safe route. Look over there. Vivian! What is with you and getting your hinder into all sorts of trouble? You really gotta learn to get your stuff together, girl. I mean, come on! Anyway, anyone might remember way back in Paper Mario 1 that in Koopa Bros. Fortress, if you jump around, you know, jump over these things over and over again, they eventually just sort of go faster and faster and faster and faster until eventually they just go out. Well, that's the same thing applies to this, except it takes significantly longer to actually get them to dissipate into monies, and you really don't get much money out of it. Yeah, like, that's it. It's really not worth the time investment. Best to just, you know, drudge forward. Also, okay, that was my foot that you done burned. Ow. Okay, well, I was merely trying to commentate on that weird lava bubble thing that was trying to attack us. Unfortunately, I got sidetracked and burned. Hoo-ah! There we go. Okay. Now, this is going to prove to be a little bit tricky. You gotta use your paper towel-based abilities. Jump over the low ones, don't jump under the big ones, and there we go. Wow, I actually remember failing a lot during that little test and trial there. Surprised I was able to do it so well. Sometimes I'm able to pull off amazing, magnificent feats, and that wasn't really one of those times. That wasn't really that hard of a challenge. It's just, you'd be surprised at how often I'm bad at this. Oh, well, this don't seem extraordinarily familiar. I smell a callback. Glurgle, gurgle, blurgle. None shall pass by. Let those who disturb her sleep fall into the depths of endless darkness. A never-ending typhlosion of various skeletons! May the intruder never find the key to this door! Alright, so this is exactly like it was back in Hooktail Castle, except the big bad main skeleton dude is actually running around in the crowd, and you can't just go to the front and fight him. You have to actually, like, hunt him down specifically. And he has a habit of being a little tricky. And there we go, found him! Alright, he's able to duck and weave around without much problem. Very, very unfortunate, but I shall defeat him nonetheless. Let's see, what am I holding on to? Oh, I picked up all of my Ultra Shrooms and Life Shrooms and Jam and Jelly from the shop before I came this way. I'm just gonna tell you now, I'm probably gonna need them. Anyway, okay, let's see. Since we're so freakishly close to leveling up anyway, why not just use the Art Attack ability? I mean, why not? I mean, I'm gonna get all my star power back immediately once I level up anyway, so might as well go whole ham on these fools. Honey roasted ham, one might say. Okay, I kind of completely messed that one up. Not sure what that was about. Okay, let's just try that again with a little more Gestapo. A little bit more pa-pa-pow, pa-pa-pow. Okay, so that didn't do too good. That wasn't the greatest, but that's okay. Now, the thing about these specific dry bones... Okay, the guys we fought way back in were actually dry bones. They were old bones. I don't know. Basically, it just means that they were weaker version of dry bones. These will eventually revive if you don't take them out entirely. So, but you can burn them, and when you do that, they die permanently and can't revive, so that's something you're definitely gonna consider. Of course, he's going to summon more of his best old buddies, because, oh no, I'm all alone, and now I need helps. I'm not strong enough of a zombie to kill these people on my own. See, that's the problem with zombies. If it's just one, it's no threat at all, but it's once there's a bazillion of them, that's when problems really start to get, you know, exceptionally bad. It's like, you know, one, two, and most maybe five zombies. That's okay. They're pretty slow and shambly. I can get away from this. But then, you know, there's like, oh my goodness gracious, this entire mini mall is absolutely packed to the brim with these people. And, you know, then it's going to be a lot harder. Then you got to get like a grocery cart and mount some pitchforks and other gardening implements onto it in order for it to, you know, to make a makeshift battering ram like I did that one time in middle school. That's an entirely different story that I will talk about at a different point in time. Right now, we've leveled up, and that's all that truly matters. That sounds extremely weird out of context. All right, well, let's see. I want more HP. Thank you, goodbye. All the HP. I will gladly take as much of it as it's willing to give. Anyway, all of the dry bones run through solid matter, as they are known to do, and we can finally proceed. This place proves to be rather treacherous and difficult of a place to navigate. This weird ancient demon apparently lives on the life of luxury because, seriously, this is a big ol' honking castle packed to the brim with baddies who are more than happy to die protecting it. It don't make much sense to me, but there you go, I suppose. Anyway, dickity bonk, take care of all these giant golden bullets. That's fine by me. However, I'd like to not have to fight them because they yield next to no benefits for doing so. Gonna have to use Vivian's hide in the shadow tricks. in order to actually get by. I'll fight the stupid cannons, but only because those are completely and totally unavoidable. Alright, and it's yep, and hop ta ta, and hop ta ta ta, yep ta ta ta, and hammer time! Woo! Ha ha! Fantastic. Alright, it's time to do battle with the evil, weird, solid gold cannon dancers once again. Most unfortunate. Okay. Okay, we just gotta do all of my super powerful attacks, and we should be able to take care of this without too much trouble! Trouble-double-double-double-double. Wow, my audience is packed full of dry bones and X-Knots. Why they're cheering for me right now, I have absolutely no idea. I mean, it makes sense. Those are the only things that would be in this place, but still very strange, I must say. Okay, Vivian, you can take care of those bullets with your fiery jinx technique. I will instead throw my hammer very vigorously towards that giant freaking cannon! Hoo-ah! Alright, not a lot of damage, but hey, something's better than nothing, I suppose. Okay, take care of this, and this, and this, and... Okay, I screwed that one up! I missed the last one, but whatever! That's enough to get rid of all of the things that I wanted dead, except your, you know, this guy here. But that's okay! We can take care of him without much problem. Okay, oh, really? You're gonna make two of these guys? That's highly unnecessary. Let me tell you right here and now that that was not a thing you needed to do. Either way, I took care of them regardless. There we go. All of the bullet bill blasters are gone, and everything is right with the world, except for the ancient demon that we still have to fight. Forgot about that. Oh yeah, forgot. There's even more of those guys running around here. Oh boy, okay. Well, there's a spectral lava bubble. They're made out of green fire, which is not a thing in science or physics or any of that other stuff where I guess fire would be one of the things you study. But there you go. Blue fire, that's an actual thing. But once it's green, you know it's like spectral and full of ghostly energies and whatnot. I meant to jump out, but for some reason my thumb missed the button to do so. Most unfortunate. Okay, yep, ba. Okay, there we go. Man, this is one really freakishly long hallway. Highly unnecessary. I mean, I know Bowser was serious about his home security, but this is an ancient demon soul. Like, apparently an ancient demon soul so freakishly and inhumanly powerful that it can totally wipe out an entire city without any problems whatsoever. So I can't really understand why it needs such high-level security. That just seems a tad bit odd to me. Just a little tiny bit. Okay. And bibbidi-bop! I'm not sure how you're able to set gold on fire so easily, Vivian, but I appreciate the fact that you can. Okay, that burns you. How about we do the spring jump? The single most difficult... Actually, it's going to be near impossible because I can't see Mario's shadow. That's unfortunate. Here goes everything! Oh, somehow I pulled it off. Only did 4 points of damage. That was more than a little disappointing. Alright, fine. Then I guess I'll just have to set everybody on fire. As you typically do when fighting, you know, armed... sentient artillery. Ugh. Sometimes talking fast. Not too good for the linguist. But it's all I know how to do, guys. I've tried to be more mellow and quiet and more reserved in my commentary, but then I just, you know, I clam up entirely, and I don't want to do that. I got my style, I like my style, and apparently if you're watching this video, if you're watching part freaking 40 of Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door, at this point, I'm willing to bet you are somewhat of a fan of my particular method of commentary as well, so there you go. Hey, the power-up defense down badge for the partner. Never gonna use it? Hey, look, Jam and Jelly, I'll be more than happy to use all that. Alright, so ultimately that room was kind of pointless if you really think about it. Interesting. Okay, so this is an interesting little room. You gotta look for the lit torch. The lit torch is on the bottom, so you want to go downstairs. Every time you advance to the right, you want to make sure you always go through the door that has the lit torch. Then eventually, through basically just perseverance and whatnot, you will eventually get to the other side. This is a common recurring theme in a lot of Mario games because do not quote me on this, but I believe this was actually one of, like, the only puzzles in the original Super Mario Brothers way back in the day that, you know, you had to actually, like, pay attention to the specific routes of each of these torches, and otherwise you just go on a never-ending loop over and over and over again, and you never know when to get off. It's like, miss the bones wild ride, I want to get off, but you can't because it goes on forever, which makes me wonder how Bowser is capable of doing something like that, but, I guess it's because he's really friggin' awesome. Then again, I guess he does have a bunch of wizards on his side, so evil dark magics could more than most likely play a large factor in how he's able to make a never-ending hallway like in Mario 64, that thing scared the poop out of me, I gotta tell you. I was an exceptionally large coward as a child. Everything scared me. Gruntilda, Bowser, things that should have never scared anyone ever, and I was completely petrified of them because that is the kind of kid I was. Luckily, I'm not really a coward. I'm not really scared of anything ever anymore. I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Perhaps I'm eternally desensitized. Not entirely sure. We gotta get out of one strange room just to find another. It's so big. It's almost like an underground city. What is this place? I do not know. Nor do I understand how this exactly works geographically exactly. Like, there's like an underground river? I mean, I'm way the ever-loving hell down here. Plus, we're behind like an... Actually, hang on. No, wait. This is running water. You can hear it running. That means either there has to be out-of-place technology to swirl the water around on a constant basis, or this water leads to an ocean. Yeah, it has to lead to an ocean. That's how water works, isn't it? So I didn't have to take the door then, is basically what I'm surmising from this information. Well, that completely and totally stinks. Get out of my way, Sir Chain Chompington of Chompingham. Alright, these guys are a bit tougher than the red ones we fought before. And by a bit, I mean extraordinarily. So, best keep up your guard and smack most justicely. There we go, fantastic. Now, Vivian, I'm not entirely sure. Are you strong enough to actually do any sort of damage to the Chain Chomp fellows? No, you are in fact not. Most unfortunate. Can I counterattack? Hoo-ah! Okay, I screwed that one up. Let's try that again and hoo-ah! Alright, I managed to do it that time. Fantastic. Okay, well, Vivian can't do anything. I'll just knock one Chain Chomp into another. And there you go. That usually gets the job done pretty good. Defend. And let's just try and counterattack. Okay, screw that one up. Let's try again. Screw it up yet again. Okay, fantastic. All right, things are not going well for the good Sir Mario, who's currently in Waluigi's clothing. Yeah, so tongue-tied all the time. Very unfortunate. Okay, can I just... Yes! Ha-ha! Take that, Chompingham! Or whatever ridiculously dignified name I decided to give you for the sake of comedy. Ha-ha! That takes care of you, which is fantastic, but there's plenty more to be done, I'm afraid. Let's see. I know for a fact that there's another one way over there. Yep, okay, found you. I will be more than happy to fight you at a later point in time. I kind of got a more important thing I'd like to do in this video before we call it a day. And what that is right beyond this door. It is a very peculiar and strange thing that we are about to witness. Also, okay, well, that is certainly a strange and bewildering thing that we've just witnessed. However, that is not what I'm talking about right now. No. I'm afraid it gets significantly more serious. Come on. We can do this, Vivian. Okay, forever. And attacked by out of nowhere Chain Chomp. Absolutely stupendously wonderful. Fantastic. Okay, fine. Okay. I suppose I was being a little overly optimistic with the idea that I would be able to actually stuff in what's about to happen, considering how long it'll probably end up taking me. So, oh boy, okay, you know what, let's just finish up this fight with these freaking dudes, and then I think it'll be a good idea to call it for the day! Freaking Chain Chomps! Okay, come on! What are these things even made out of? They can't be iron. My hammer is clearly made out of iron at one point or another, and it still barely does anything. It don't make no sense. Okay. Also, for some reason, apparently earthquakes are able to help hurt Chain Chomps. That don't make no sense neither. Nothing makes sense in this world. Okay, can I... No, I'm never able to do it. Alright, you know what? I suppose this was all for the best because I lost way too much health in this encounter. Okay, so in the next part, I will continue down this hallway, and we will find out what I'm alluding to. I'm sure anybody who's played this game knows full well what we're about to get ourselves into, and it will be extraordinarily amazing and stupendous. At least I like to think so. Hopefully you guys had a fantastic time, and I'll see you all next time!